Just imagine that you're at the university train station and frustrated waiting for a train that's been delayed. It is very likely that your train was delayed because of a switch and crossing failure. Now, what exactly are switches and crossings? Switches and crossings are a very important part of the railway infrastructure that enable trains to change tracks. You can see an example of one on my slide. According to Network Rail, switches and crossings occupy just 4% of the total UK track mileage, but they attribute to 23% of maintenance and renewal budgets of Network Rail. Therefore, by using the first principles of engineering, my research looks at why this happens and what can be done to mitigate this. In railway engineering, there's a field called condition monitoring, wherein you install sensors on the infrastructure. You use these sensors in order to gather data, such as forces on tracks. You then use this data to predict faults on the infrastructure. I discovered that in my field, these sensors were being placed randomly on the infrastructure rather than in a systematic manner. Therefore, I developed a novel numerical tool which is capable of telling us where to install these sensors on the track. So, as you can see on the Venn diagram of my slide, my research comprises of three different aspects. The first aspect is to carry out numerical simulation of vehicle and track in order to determine the placement of sensors on them. The second is to choose the highest quality of sensors to get the best quality of data. And the third is to use that data in order to predict faults on the infrastructure. So the novel numerical approach that I used in order to simulate the interaction between the vehicle and the track is called the finite element method. In the finite element method, the wheel, switch and crossing, and other parts of the infrastructure are discretized or divided into hundreds of thousands of finite elements. Each of these elements is then analyzed individually using the different laws of physics in finite element software. So, due to the level of detail considered, my switch and crossing model is also able to replicate different environmental conditions, such as leaf fall season or frost on tracks. I also validated my model by comparison against field measurements. This was done by taking outputs such as forces and accelerations from a high-speed switch and crossing in Warwick and then comparing them against my simulation outputs. In the future, we are going to see the implementation of digital technologies in massive infrastructure projects in the UK, such as HS2 and Crossrail. My research supports the implementation of these digital technologies. So hopefully, by the time we have our new university train station in 2022, you and I should be able to travel on a safer and a more punctual railway network. Thank you very much.